Essequibo, we went to visit another coconut farm. We were on the banks of the Essequibo River. This is Farica police station. And the weather is not so much in our favor. However, let's make the most of it. Let's enjoy and see what this journey holds. This is Farica City. We're heading to the river now to join Essequibo. Take us to Supana. That's a journey of about 45 minutes. And from there we join another vehicle to take us down to the Pomeroon River. Join me on this journey. It promises a lot, though the day is rainy. This is the main mode of transportation. They can be considered as river taxis. It will take you to the numerous parts of this huge river. That ferry has scheduled sailing, but you can take any one of these boats to get you to your destination faster.
Given the size of the boat and the number of passengers, space to freely maneuver was very limited. And off we go, quickly leaving Parica Stelling and the east bank of the Essequibo behind us. We traveled out to the open river and it is relatively calm, despite the few times we were thrown around with the occasional and sudden bob and weave of the wooden speedboat. There, through the opening, we got a good view of the mighty Essequibo with a low skyline hanging ominously, clouds pregnant with rain. This is one of the largest rivers of Guyana with a width of 20 miles at the mouth and running all the way from the south for 630 miles or 1,014 kilometers before reaching the Atlantic Ocean on the north coast of the South American continent. This river takes birth near the Brazilian border and drains more than half of Guyana. There are 365 islands in this river.
After about a 30 minutes drive on the Essequibo River, we have arrived at the western bank. This is the community of Supana. From here we head to Pomeroon.
This is one of three counties of Guyana and referred to as the Cinderella County, the others being Demerara and the ancient county of Borbis. Cinderella, a girl whose beauty or merit is for a time unrecognized. Quite a description. Female and beautiful. Let's discover together the beauty of Essequibo. A short stop over to visit the local coconut water factory, but not before lunch and a quick chat. The hospitality has been exceptional and ought to be underlined. On behalf of the team I'm traveling with, comprising of foreign delegates drawn from Central America, the Caribbean and Europe, I take the liberty to extend gratitude to Mr. Rupan Ramotar from Rooster's Products for his receptivity and kind courtesy extended. It was quick. The stalk is inserted, and before you say boo, you have juice. The cane juice is fresh and satisfying. It's been a while since I've had such a drink. We're traveling along the coast, which is at an average 6 feet below sea level and prone to occasional floods if not properly managed. The network of canals, together with the construction style of houses and buildings being two-story, are an inheritance from Dutch colonization. Apart from drainage and irrigation, these canals had provided the major mode of transportation during the days of sugar. Guyana in its entirety did not escape the deluge that day, with the dramatic climatic changes the world over. There is no telling when it is a dry and rainy season. Once upon a time, there used to be two rainy seasons and two dry seasons in the north of Guyana, where we are now. From May to June and from December to January were the two rainy seasons. The open fields of water are areas where rice is cultivated. The fertility of the soil is very evident by the vegetation present. Rice, and then more rice, and coconut palms near and far. The greenery is worthy for postcard pictures. Cinderella is indeed very present here. This area forms part of Guyana coastal region, which the Dutch had referred to as the Wilde Kust or the Wild Coast. Actually, the Dutch had claimed all of the Guyanas, which had included Spanish Guayana in Venezuela, Portuguese Guyana, which forms part of northern Brazil, French Guyana, which is still an overseas French territory, Dutch Guyana, which is Suriname today, and British Guyana, which is now the Cooperative Republic of Guyana. In 1598, a fleet of three Dutch ships on a visit to this wild coast had referred to this river as Surinamo, but that was about a year after the British would have done the same. Colonists had arrived some years earlier, in 1581, from mainly the province of Zeeland in the Netherlands. And trading posts were set up not only in the Pomeroon, but in Essequibo, Burbies, and Suriname rivers. However, diseases and attacks from the native Amerindians, these colonies lasted a very short time initially, until years after, when fortifications were done to make some of them more established. These colonies in Essequibo and Demerara were controlled by the Dutch West India Company, while the Society of Burbies and the Society of Suriname control those regions, respectively. In the aftermath of the Napoleonic Wars in 1814, there were many changes, and Britain gained control of the colonies of Essequibo, Demerara, and Burbies, which became British Guyana, and then modern Guyana. I am witnessing here life in the open countryside, simple and free, wrapped in the bosom of nature, life being lived with mainly the offerings of nature, life devoid of pollution so pronounced in many big cities, devoid of contaminated air belched by huge factories, life not lived on the edge, life being lived with many privileges people in other places lack. Water, healthy rainforests, very fertile soil, cultivations, homegrown food, self-sufficiency. It is just unfortunate that many a time these privileges go unnoticed and taken for granted. There are riches here. The colonizers knew it and fought many a battle for it. Some people have found it, and we can see manifestations of it. The world is screaming to grow more food, and this place has much more to offer. Cinderella is her name. The Pomeroon River is the deepest of Guyana's rivers, measuring a depth of 60 feet, while in some places a full 90. The river runs inland for more than 200 miles and flows in a northwesterly course into the Atlantic, unlike the other major rivers of this country, which flow more south to north. Pomeroon. But this may very well be a different way of spelling coconuts, as it is the first thought which comes to mind when one hears mention of this name. Unofficially, it is recognized as the coconut capital of the Caribbean, with large-scale production of this fruit. I have had the opportunity of traveling to a number of countries so far, and tasted coconut water in those places, but not because I am Guyanese. But coconut water from the Pomeroon is the best I have tasted until now. We head into a tributary of the main river and quickly arrived at our final destination at Rooster's farm. This farm is one of about 500 acres of coconut palms of the 3-year-old variety. It looks well taken care of.
Today we're visiting Rooster's farm in the Pomeroon River. We are about 10 minutes drive from the mouth of the river. This is a 500 acres farm, we are told. And the coconuts that you see there, they're of the 3-year-old type.
It was a short visit, but one to inspire. It is indeed a unique experience. We boarded once more to visit the mouth of the Pomeroon River, which should be a short drive away. Take note of the river transport system here, as there are no roads reaching this far, nor is there internet connection. Take note as well of the level of water in the river compared to the farmlands. The water level is higher, hence the embolderments along the banks of the river to keep the water out. The number of coconut trees is amazing, and the greenery is impressive. This is nature in all its glory and splendor. The dark tea brown water is rich in sediments and would have acquired its coloration from flowing through the wetlands and swamps and forests as it surged through the open ocean. Like this river, I myself had searched for greener pastures, a better life. While yet a teenager, I had joined a boat full of human cargo and embarked upon a journey to Venezuela, traveling through this very passage. That journey impacted, in a meaningful way, the course my life took during the subsequent years. I had left these shores in the darkness of night, but my recollection of that moment is with much clarity, as I headed with hope into a world of a lot of uncertainties. The Coast Guard is present here, and their permission is required for you to traverse in and out of the river. Approval, and we headed outwards.
The forest,
and it brings all the sediments and the nutrients, and they it comes here to the ocean, and that's why we have so many big fish. So instead of as a Guyanese, proud of the brown rivers of Guyana.
Guys, don't believe her; she's kidding. That's Coca-Cola we have there.
Where the river meets the ocean is usually rich fishing grounds, and a variety of marine life can be found here. We soaked in the view for a few more minutes before we return on our journey.
About to board the ferry.
If they open the door?
If they open the door, it's already closed. I hope they give us some consideration and open the door. And
what is it?
Colorful one.
Thank you, Captain.
And the wet one.